My name is Henning Malmgren. I'm the CCO for Asia Pacific for DAMCO, having spent a couple of years out here already. The changing in the space of supply chain and manufacturing is very much about the changing in the markets. Traditional, the markets were very much, you know, production in Asia and then shipped off to North America and Europe. But in the last 5, 6, 7, 8 years, we have seen a lot more of the consumption taking place in Asia. So the emerging markets in Asia, China, India, Indonesia, Philippines coming, maybe Myanmar in the future. So manufacturing, yes, still out here, but much more of the sales taking place out here. And that then changes a lot of the dynamics in and around supply chains. Well, the future is probably still linked to the emerging markets. I think many of the manufacturers will have to adjust some of their strategies, and they will be going into new markets, and they will need supply chains that can support their growth in new markets from a sales point of view, but also from a sourcing point of view. Here in Asia, there's a lot of interesting markets opening up, and we all see a general shift from China production to other places in Southeast Asia, Indonesia, Vietnam, or even Bangladesh. Well, the growth opportunities are in and around those emerging markets. Retailers will come to this part of the world and open their sales outlets. Growth for us is also into new markets. Myanmar is a good example, where we have people on the ground now, office registered and ready to go and setting up consolidation facilities. So we're ready to take on business in places like Myanmar as well. I think there's a couple of challenges. We already talked about the change in their supply chains, change in markets. We see more and more of our customers with fewer and fewer resources, fewer and fewer or less and less travel budgets. I think there will be also going forward more cost consciousness, more reliance on people like ourselves who are globally on the ground on behalf of our customers. Some of that will go in that direction. It's all about making supply chain solutions together with your customers and together with your partners. If you are reactively, as a logistics provider, waiting for your customer to come and tell you what he needs in the future, then you're going to be left behind. So you need to get your relationship with your customers to a much more strategic level and be there and build the future plans together with them. I think you can say that DAMCO is doing a couple of different things. First of all, we still have an extreme focus on our customers. You see a lot of companies out there, our competitors, some of them, with a very strong product focus, so it's air freight or sea freight or trucking, where our focus is much more in and around the customer and trying to solve their future challenges together with them or their future opportunities. And specifically in and around some of the dynamic flow controlling that we are putting in place for some of our customers, expanded control towers that enables centralized decision making with real time. And then I think the next thing that will require a little bit more attention is, I still think there's a big market in the online servicing, online retailing. And then I think nearshoring is going to be an interesting opportunity in the future. We see places like Turkey for the European market or North Africa coming back. We see places like Mexico for the North American market. So there's still plenty of things out there that needs to get done. Well, the event is quite good. I see still there's some energy. Still it's first day. I think it's well visited. We have had a lot of visitors coming to our stand here as well. We've had good discussions, existing customers and new customers, new friends are being made. So far, so good.